Hi, everybody! Welcome to another episode. Ooh. We're gonna be doing Deadlands now, cause that's the game that you guys suggested I play next. Or not the game, but like the. You got it. You understand. All right. So, this is the spooky one. So hopefully there isn't actually anything that scary in it, because again, I'm a little wuss. I'm a little wuss wimp. Wimpy wuss man. Do I not have a builder? Oh, no, they're both archer. Okay, hopefully there is a, thank god. If I made a mistake right off the bat. But yeah, Kingdom Deadlands. Hopefully it won't take me 30 episodes. Hopefully. Don't quote me on it. It might happen. But yeah, so, what I'm gonna be trying to do now is maybe like 30 minute episodes. See how that is. Thank you. But yeah, let's just talk about stuff. So, I don't really know a lot about Kingdom Deadlands. So no big spoilers. Yeah, I see you guys. So we're just gonna, I should probably actually make walls. That would probably be smart. Let's get you to go back. I forgot I can do this. Walls! No, it's not walls. I made a mistake. Okay. So hopefully, we'll be able to be good at this game. Who knows? Compared to, the last time I played, which took 30 episodes to actually beat the game, that should probably take like an hour or two. Again, I'm bad at games. I'm sorry, guys. You guys aren't watching me for being extremely good and tactical and... Oh, look at the big brain moves! Ah! No, I'm more just really dumb. I do the dumb stuff. That's what I'm here for. I do the stuff that makes you think, why, Flobo, why? There's something way more, you could do this, which is way more efficient, Flobo. Why are you doing it like that? I'm that guy. You're here for that, probably. And if you didn't know, that's what you're gonna be here for. I'm sorry in advance. But yeah. So. I'm used to the Phoenix. I'm not used to bad horse. Alright, so far, first impressions, like the art style, very nice. I like how the walls are different. Oh, is there even a wall here? Hey, I'm not gonna say anything. I'm okay with this outcome. Alright, let's get another builder and get this done. So at least we're gonna be okay. Don't quote me. But yeah, what to talk about? Well, one thing I'm gonna do real quick is, change this out. What should we be? We should be... Let's be this deer. How about that? Yeah, there we go. First impressions, like the art, it's very nice, even though it's still pixelated. I like how it's different from the previous game, or not game, but you understand, shush. What to talk about? We got 25 minutes to get through. So... One of the things we can talk about is, we got a Discord now. So, if any of you reoccurring viewers that oh so love my content. Oh! if any of you guys want to come and join the Discord, it's on... It's on the Reddit, yep. But I'll probably put like the link in the description or something. Nah. Hey. Spoopy. All right. So yeah. Discord, very nice. I tried my best to make it look pretty. I'm not very good. I've never really made a Discord before. I didn't make it. I see you right there. One of you guys made it. So very, very thankful for that. Thank you very much for making that for me. For us, I should say. For the community. But yeah, so if you want to join, come over. It might not look the prettiest because I don't know how to make. I tried my best. One of the things I would really like to have inside of it are some bots, so it looks like oh cool professional and servers and stuff. But I'm not technologically savvy enough. Sorry. Yeah, so that's what's going on there. Also, I promised, and while watching back that 3-hour train wreck of an episode, just get you out right now. While watching back that 3-hour train wreck of an episode last time, or like editing it, I did not actually talk about my, like, the D&D stuff that I wanted to talk about, or gush about, because, I lost my train of thought. Who would have guessed? So, I guess I'll talk about it now. yep. Alright, so yeah, I guess I'll talk about it now. So, basically, D&D. I love the game. It's fun. I haven't played it for years, and I haven't played it in years, but fun. I haven't played a lot of games, but every game I've played, I've just gotten such weird scenarios. Like, I make fun characters. I make fun characters. So, my most proud character that I made was my Warforge bard called Cupduck. I love him. He's my pride and joy. He's my baby boy. Other characters that come to mind are my tabaxi monk. I forgot what his name was, but he was like addicted to drugs without knowing it. And then after I had a Kenku for like a one shot that I did called Yano. And he was a traumatized little boy. That couldn't speak because that's how Kenkus work. I should really explore a little bit. Hold on, let me explore a little bit. I don't actually know where the boat is. That should probably be like my number one priority. So Yano, pretty funny. I whenever I played him, I kind of had to play charades with everybody because, again, I wanted to talk, but I can't talk if nobody. Like says anything that I can repeat, but still pretty funny. But again, my pride and joy is Cupduck, because he's the character that I've played the most. And oh cool, it's the archer thing. I like how it's different from the original one. Very nice, very much enjoy. Can you stay? Sorry about that. The arm for my pot filter is not very strong. It doesn't like to stay in place, so sorry about that little cut. Back to Cupduck. So he's my pride and joy because he's the character that I played the longest. Not one session. A couple sessions, and then after there was like a one shot that I did, that I was able to play him again. So, one session and like a one shot that I played, and oh my god, let me tell you about the wacky hijinks I got into. So, the first session, usually it's pretty chill, right? For people who actually play D&D, I see you there. I see you. So, first session, usually pretty chill. Nothing really goes on. Maybe like some lore dumping. It's basically, first session, trying to get to know the other people you're playing with. My first session was us playing for a bit. And then after, I got stuck in a alternate dimension for 3 sessions. Yeah, so that's how my character went. He didn't die, though. He eventually got out. But for the first 3 sessions of the game, I wasn't technically playing the game. I would just be sitting aside while everybody was playing the game, while I was just, I don't know, scrolling through my phone or something. Because, I wasn't able to play the game since I was in a different dimension. Granted, yes, it was kind of my fault. I kind of just went inside of a portal without thinking. But at the same time, they were talking about, oh yes, so there's a portal that opened up and stuff like that after you defeated this like little mini encounter boss thing. And like, if you open up a portal, I'm expecting you to want us to go inside of it. So I just went into it. And the DM didn't expect that. So as soon as that happened, he decided to shut the portal behind me just in case anybody else went inside of it. And so yeah, I was stuck in an alternate dimension in like an orb, because like after the portal like became big and all that, it got shrunk down into like a little orb to get carried around by my party. And yeah, I was just stuck in a different dimension, like surrounded by doors that led to different dimensions like hell and like heaven and stuff like that. Level 1. Heck yeah. And then after eventually 3 sessions later, I got out. Okay, so here's the dock. Cool. Got it. Let me go back and see if I can get builder so I can get that built. But yeah, pretty funny. Also, some other things that Cupduck did. Cupduck. Okay, so first of all, let me explain Cupduck, alright? Cupduck is a warforged, so basically just a robot that's lived for a long time. So Cupduck, he's a warforged bard that his entire quest in life is to try and figure out what love is, because he is a robot that doesn't understand the emotion of love. So, I made it, so, and I talked to my DM about this, so whenever I do anything that has, like, is, like, romantic or, like, love-related or anything like that, I have disadvantage on the roll, just to show you how bad Cupduck is with the ladies, or technically men, too, because, Cupduck a robot, he can go either way. But, yeah, so he was a Warforged bard that was really bad at flirting and, like, anything relationship-wise. He had 2 magical drumsticks. I forgot to say. He's not just a bard. He's a jazz musician. Yeah. I made my, Warforged a jazz musician bard that, had magical drumsticks. So he played, free jazz with his magical drumsticks. And the best thing about... Oh, by the way, magical drumsticks, what it basically was, I'm not gonna do that because the son's about to say. Basically, what happens with his magical drumsticks is, he can basically play air drums, so I don't need to carry a drum set with me all the time. All I need is my magical drumsticks, and after I can go, ba-doom-t. That, again, right there, that's another reason why magical drumsticks were amazing, because whenever anybody at the table made a horrible, horrible joke, I can just go, ba-doom-t. Anytime I wanted to. It was amazing. It was funny. I loved it. It was a pretty fun character to play. So let me tell you some other stuff about Kupchak and what he did. So we were kind of hurting on, well, not we, but Kupchak was kind of hurting on money, and we recently got to like level 2. So in my persuasion or my charisma, is that a chicken? Did you speak? Hello? Hello? Oh. So yeah, my Kupchak, his charisma was a +7, which was kind of insane. But yeah. So his charisma was a +7. So I felt like I was basically God with a silver tongue. So what I tried to do, because I was tight on money, is I tried to pawn off a rock or sell a rock off and try to pawn it off as a great historical artifact. Do you guys know the story of what's the religious story called? The story of like Andre the Giant or something like that. I don't remember the name of it. No, David and Goliath. Hey, Andre the Giant. That's a that's a wrestler. David and Goliath. If you know the story, if you don't know the story, let me just say it out real quick. So the Goliath, really big guy in the army, and David, really small, short king. I'm pretty sure. Gotta represent. Yeah, so what he decided to do was grab this little rock, put it in the slingshot, and shoot it at the Goliath. And he was able to kill this big, massive Goliath war guy with just one stone that hit him right in between the eyes. So my bard, Kupchak, decided to try and sell off this pebble that he found on the side of the street, forge some documents to legitimize, major quotation marks, legitimize how real this historical artifact was, and try to sell it off as the stone from David and Goliath, which me personally I thought was funny as all hell. My DM, on the other hand, I don't think he enjoyed it, because I am pretty sure he made me fail that. Who cares? It's not like I was, I spent money on it at all. It was a rock that I picked up on the side of the street, so, I'm fine with it. But, yeah, I thought it was pretty funny that I tried to do that. Some other things, that Kupchak is notably known for is being a sewer goblin and traumatizing children. Yeah, so let me get into that. So... so I forgot exactly what we were doing. I think we were killing giant rats in the sewer or something. I forgot, but we were in the sewer. I forgot exactly what we were doing. And, what Kupchak decided to do was he found a sewer crate to like the, outside, and he was able to, with, dancing lights, he was able to, shoot off one of his dancing lights outside of the sewer grate. And a child came to the sewer grate to see what the heck that was. And as soon as he, like, looked down in the sewer grate, because as soon as he got close enough, I kind of brought the glowing orb back down into the sewer. As soon as... as soon as he got down... sorry, I'm remembering this and it's making me laugh. As soon as he got down and, like, looked in the side of the sewer to figure out what this, like... light was, Kupchak decided to grab the kid's arm and, like, started, like maniacally laughing. And after, like, run off and scatter off, he basically grabbed it and go, and just run down the sewer. And from that, the child got traumatized and, like, ran away telling the guards that there's, like, a sewer goblin or something like that. And whenever we got out of the sewer and stuff, we saw, like, a bunch of guards near the sewer grate, just trying to figure out what the hell the kid was talking about, and it was the funniest thing ever. Oh, but don't worry, I got more stuff that Cupduck did. So, Cupduck. Okay, so, first of all, Cupduck, we made it to level 2 for it, these characters. And whenever my DM, I don't know if this is like normal, but my DM, what he likes to do is whenever you, like, when our characters level up, he gives us a brief period of time to like really like level them up. So it's not just like, oh, cool, I wake up, I know how to do everything now. He gives us time to like actually learn the things that we get from leveling up and stuff like that. So yeah, we just recently made it to this new town. And we basically said, all right, in 3 days' time, we'll meet back here. And yeah, so then after we all went on our separate ways, and in 3 days' time, we're going to meet back at the center of town. Because then after, we're going to all be leveled up. Yay! So, let me skip ahead to what happened. So, 2 days later. Everybody except for Cupduck is at the fountain, at the beginning of the, whatchamacallit, at the start of the, at the entrance of the town, or like at the, you know, in the center of the town. And basically, this is what they see. They see Cupduck running from across the town towards them, wearing a bright, Not bright, but like a deep purple pimp outfit.
Mr. Dubois, my name is a pimp named Slickback, and this, sir, is an intervention.
Running away with a giant, maybe all the guard. I forgot how he like described it, but I'm pretty sure it was every single guard that was in the town at that point running towards him. He runs by the party saying, "Get out! Get out! Run!" Runs by them and runs out of town. That's what my party gets witness to. So basically, again, reiterating, nothing happened for when they got there. Everybody was normal. We said, "We'll meet back here in 2 days' time." In 2 days' time, Cupduck's wearing a pimp outfit and running away for his life from a massive group of guards. So, let me explain what happened. So, basically, this is what happened. While I was trying to find myself and learn my new skills and stuff, I tried to find other bards to, like, you know, hang out with and tell tales and stuff. You know, bard stuff. I was able to apparently find one, but he was really weird because he was wearing a purple pimp outfit. Let me continue. Whenever I met him, I was like, "Oh, hey man, how you doing? Are you a fellow bard? I like what you're wearing. You look pretty cool." And he looked at me with crazed eyes saying, "Here, yeah, you can have it if you like it," and just gave me his clothes. And then after I was like, "Oh, thanks, man," and I put them on, thinking nothing of it. Not even like 10 minutes later, a guard looks in my direction saying, "There he is, get him!" Apparently, this bard, I'm now thinking that they weren't a bard, they were just mentally insane. I don't exactly know what they did. I'm assuming they either stole this pimp outfit or they were wanted for some pretty awful stuff. I've never actually got to know because this was this was the last session that we actually did. So I think maybe my DM got a little sick of me. I don't know. Don't quote me. So what happened next was I'm starting to run for my life. Granted, I could have probably, because again, I had a +7 in persuasion at that point. I could have probably talked to them, the guards, and probably persuaded them, but okay, no, that is 4 archers. But who's gonna do that? not Cup Duck. Nah, he's gonna not think about it and just run for his life, cause he doesn't want to get arrested. Who wants to get arrested? So after I'm getting chased out of the town, I'm a bad storyteller, cause I can't help but laugh at my own stories, and by doing that, I kind of like take little pauses, cause again, I'm laughing. I'm sorry, but so after I'm starting to get chased by the guard, I was whoa, hey, there's more things on this island. What is this? I guess we'll see. Whoops, not that's the wrong island. And again, what happened was I ran out of the town. Past my fellow adventurers, telling them to run with me, because again, I was getting chased by like at least 20 of them, 20 guards at least. That's Cup Duck. Then after, there was a one-shot campaign that I did that I forgot exactly what we were doing. It was something to do with like a murder mystery or something like that. But we were all invited to this fancy ball and stuff like that. So I say stuff like that a lot. Ugh. But yeah, we were all invited to this very fancy, very posh ball and stuff. So I was allowed to wear my pimp outfit from the previous campaign I played. Thank God, because it's a dang pimp outfit. Come on, how much more fancy can you get? So I forgot exactly what happened. All I remember is that Cup Duck got very bored of the fancy posh music, and having the true bard spirit, he wanted to do some music playing of his own. So he decided to get the band to cooperate with him and teach them some new sheet music that he's been learning. And in this very fancy ball, he decided to play Daft Punk's Harder, Better, Faster, Stronger. And I was able to roll a nat 20 on performance, so everybody, even the most snobbiest of person, started busting down sexual style to Harder, Better, Faster, Stronger by Daft Punk. And again, I'm a robot, so I can do those robotic voices, which is really nice to hear. So just imagine, if you guys know the song, or just imagine the song, or play it after you watch this video, and imagine a Warforged bard playing his heart out, and a bunch of fancy noble people dancing to like techno music. It was the best. I loved it. I think I made the DM a little annoyed, but still, it was fun. I enjoyed it at least. So, if you're ever wondering what kind of player I am, that's what kind of player I am. I'm the one that's, I'm not like a min-maxer or anything, even though, again, it seems like I would be with a fucking plus 7 on charisma. But I'm not a min-maxer or anything like that. I just try and make the most fun stories out of what I have, which apparently, as you can tell by me getting trapped in an alternate dimension in the first chapter that I ever played, or the first session, I should say, that I ever played, I'm a pretty fun player. That's gonna be it for me, guys. Thank you very much for watching me, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye! Hello, it's me, Flobo. Thank you very much for watching till the end of the episode. I very much appreciate it. In the description is our Reddit and my social medias if you're interested. But other than that, I hope that you have a wonderful day.